Calendly helps you schedule meetings without the back. Can we replace that photo? Calendly helps you schedule meetings without the back and that's so much worse.
Sorry.
We're going to teach four different ways to connect Calendly to Webflow. We'll cover a simple link, we'll embed a calendar right in our design, we'll do a pop-up widget, and we'll do pop-up text. Part zero, let's first sign up with Calendly. If you've already done this and you've connected your calendar, you can skip to part one. This is their marketing site. We can sign up if we haven't already. This part's important for two reasons. Number one, it lets us sync our calendar account. In our case, we're syncing with Google Calendar. This way, we can prevent calendar collisions or double booking appointments. And it'll synchronize any appointments made through Calendly. Now, you can go back and configure these connections under calendar connections at any time. Okay, let's go back home. That's part zero. This is part one. How do we copy a booking link? Whatever event we want to schedule, let's copy the link. Back to the desk.
This is awkward.
In Webflow, we want to paste that direct link, and we'll use a button here. We're just going in and pasting the URL. When you publish the project, pressing that button takes you to the scheduler on Calendly. That's part one. Part two, inline embed. Let's go in and choose to add this event to our website. Three options. To save time, we're going to cover all three of these at once. Click the option you want, press continue, then copy the code to your clipboard. Now, why did we just do a three across design with three separate recordings? Would it have saved time if we just copied and pasted the same video three times? And doesn't describing that now exceed the time we saved by doing this anyway?
I'm not even following.
We can do a sentence diagram.
Are you serious?
Since we selected inline embed and copied the code to our clipboard, all we have to do is paste it in a custom code embed in Webflow. So let's drag that into our layout. We're just dragging in an embed element. Is that all? No, now we paste. Save and close. Let's publish our changes. If we go to the live site, Calendly. Now, you might notice a scroll bar. This is part of Calendly's design, and it works great for selecting a time, especially if you have absolutely nothing on your calendar, like Stacy. If that's an inline embed, what does a pop-up widget look like? Like this. There's a picture and a description right on the page, which we'll zoom into now. You can configure what you want to configure for the pop-up widget, then copy that code to your clipboard. Back in Webflow, all you have to do is go to the page settings for whatever page we want the pop-up widget to appear on whatever page we want the pop-up widget to appear. Let's paste this before the closing of the body tag. We're just pasting the code we copied to our clipboard. Now, why are we pasting it here? Let's save changes, by the way. Can we use an embed element instead? Sure, but to keep things clean, we're putting the code, we're pasting it in our page settings, so the embed element isn't messing with our layout preview. Let's go in and publish the page, and if we go to that page, it's right where it should be. That's a pop-up widget. What about a pop-up text? Which, saying aloud, makes far less sense than calling it text pop-up, because that's what it is. A text link that launches the Calendly pop-up. Pop-up text sounds like a keynote effect. Let's select pop-up text. You know what? Let's go in and change this. Right click, inspect element. Let's go into the code in our browser and change it to text pop-up, which is significantly better. Let's continue. Copy the code. Back in Webflow, we have our layout. Let's add an embed event. Let's paste in the code, save and close. Now, since it's a text link, it's going to inherit the text properties of whatever parent in the hierarchy is. There's a better way to say this. Because the parent of our HTML embed is the content div block, this could be any div block, any section or container that's a parent element, we can affect the text styling on that parent. And it should pass down, the text styling changes we make should affect the HTML embed. So if we tweak our content div block, we can go over and publish. And when we open the published page, we can see it matches the styling perfectly. But does it? Yes. Now, we can always go back and customize each of these options in Calendly. And if we do, it's important to copy the new code to our clipboard, the updated code, and repaste that code back in Webflow. But that's it. We covered adding a direct link, an inline embed, a pop-up widget, and pop-up text. All of it integrating Calendly into Webflow. As for people wanting to schedule time on Stacy's calendar, as of this recording, her official Webflow calendar is still linked to this demo site.